tons during this storm. The men, women, and children of the earth, come forth to gather.
Well, how do you feel? Oh, I know it does, dear. But it's for a good cause. Try not to squirm so much while I take notes. Now, how would you describe the pain you're feeling? Any advice for how to keep it from being overwhelming? And remember, this is for posterity. Ah, yes. That makes a lot of sense. And it does help when you're sewing up wounds and setting bones, too. That seems like it'd be tough to do alone. Luckily, I'm here to patch you up. Now hold still and quit fidgeting.
Ugh, how can you be walking around like this?
Okay, I even stitched a little smiley face in you to keep up your spirits. It's kind of hard to see from your side, though. Here, take this environment suit of mine. It will help with medical tasks, and it should help prevent the effects of exposure, too. There's a sort of mole rat repellent I've developed. I need it to be tested on a few mole rats before I can say it's a success. There's a lot we don't know about mire lurks and how intelligent and dangerous they are. That definitely deserves research. And that should be it for the second chapter. Mole rats can... It'll be easy. One tap with the applicator and it... Oh, you could test it out on just a few mole ratties, but...
What's up, Wastelanders? This is Three Dog Bow Wow, and you're listening to GNR. You forgot. Got lots of stuff going down in post-apocalyptia these days. Here's some of the latest news. It's time for an update on that Vault 101 Peacekeeper. A gal who proves that not everyone out there is a complete asshole. Got some great news out of the town of Megaton. Turns out the live atomic bomb in the town center has finally been deep-sixed for good. The town sheriff, one Lucas Sims, commissioned the one, the only lone wanderer from Vault 101 to disarm the nasty nuke. And the kid delivered. Hey, nice work, 101. Next time you're in the neighborhood, pop into the studio. Old Three Dogs, Toaster's been on the fritz. Children, this is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. Now, some music.
Wound the clock since the Puritans got the shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock, olden days, a glimpse of stocking was the thought of something shocking. But now God knows anything goes. Good offers to once knew better words, now only used for letter words, writing prose. Anything goes. cars you like, if low bars you like, if old hymns you like, if Bear Limb you like, if Mae West you like, or me undressed you like, why nobody will oppose when you like, why nobody will oppose when every night the sets and smart is intruding at nudist parties in studio. McLean got yeser than I suppose. Anything goes when Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Max Gordon produce his show. Anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good bad today. And those pains you got in any brain you got from those little radios. So Mrs. R, with all her trim, can broadcast the bed from Simmons, cause Frank knows. Anything goes.
I'm tickled pink that things are rosy and skies are blue once again. Let the bygones go bye-bye.
Kick ass!